Hello everybody, my name is Yona and this is Kabajiro Draws. And I am starting today's video off in front of my bookshelf. Yes, it's a rainbow, and yes, I do know where everything is, because I thought instead of doing another studio vlog or a specifically art-related video, as you can see, I like books, and especially I like graphic novels, so this is a video all about my favorite graphic novels. That makes sense. Did that sentence make sense? Not really. But anyways, I have a bunch of graphic novels behind me. I'm going to be pulling them out and showing you why I like them, the art, who drew them. So if it's author plus artist, specifically the artist, because I feel like those are often, they are often underappreciated. And I just want to share what I really enjoy and hope you find some that maybe you haven't heard of before or that you really, really like. So yeah. So the first two books that we have here are Neil Gaiman novellas illustrated by Daniel Ignaeus. They're not really graphic novels, but they are fully illustrated. And what I really like is how the art wraps around the text. It's similar to Neil Gaiman's Neverwhere. Here you have the full information on the artist. I really love this kind of more graphic editorial style. And I really, really like how both of these books play with shapes and colors. I mean, the inside is all black and white, but you can see the covers are beautifully done. Here are some of the pages. I don't want to spoil it all. These books are still available. You can get them most places. They were a limited edition. They come also with American Gods and Anansi Boys, which are only chapter titles illustrated, not fully, because those books are very, very thick. But yeah, really, really recommend the illustrations in here. They are gorgeous. This time, Chris Riddle, again, the novel or the story by Neil Gaiman. Chris Riddle has a really very recognizable style. He did most of the Neil Gaiman children's books. He's very active with illustrating in general, and I really like the black, white, and gold here. Pause again to read more about Chris Riddle if you don't know everything about him already. Are they gonna stand? Kind of, let's see. Here is a graphic novel that I know a lot of people love, and I didn't really love it as much. If you've seen my Reading Rush Challenge video, you know that's when I read it. I think it's the second video on this channel. The art is pretty, it's well done, it's a huge book, and it's Scott McCloud's graphic novel debut. You might know Scott McCloud from the How To comic series, I think it's called. Really, really influential and taught a lot of people how to make comics. Sad that his first comic is actually quite bad. Next we have Habibi by Craig Thompson. It's all done by hand, the patterns, everything. I met Craig Thompson when I also met Scott McCloud at a graphic novel and literary festival in Vienna. The book is beautiful. I haven't fully read through it. I started it ages ago, and I've heard that the representation in it is not great, so I'm not sure I'm gonna recommend it. But what I did really enjoy is Blankets, also by Craig Thompson. This is the one that got him really, really famous. It's a story of him growing up, and again has that striking brush style, which is just very well done, very expressive, and very beautiful. I enjoyed Blankets. I did not enjoy Habibi, and I've stopped supporting the author. But the next graphic novel we have, I absolutely do support, and it's amazing. And it's originally a web comic. You can read it for free online at Check Please. And that's what also has this webcomic format, but it is absolutely beautiful. Here you have all the information on it, and I highly recommend you check it out. It's about a queer, pie-loving ice hockey player. This is Palestine by Joe Sacco. Joe Sacco does reporting through the style of graphic novels. So again, this is from Palestine. It's well loved. It's absolutely beautifully done, and it's very emotional and informative. There's a lot of text, there's a lot of great illustration, and this is just a very unique approach to the graphic novel format. Uli Lust's Heute ist der letzte Tag vom Rest seines Lebens is, well, as you can see, a German graphic novel, but there is also an English translation, so you can get it. And it's about her completely whacked, crazy life. She has a few autobiographical stories, and they are really, really interesting. At the end, you can find diary entries and notes showing that it all really happened, which is probably the craziest part. The art is very expressive, but not technically that skilled. The Schwab's Shade of Magic comic, I just included because it was right next to all my other red books on the bookshelf. It's the Steel Prince series, it's a few volumes. I don't have them all, I only have this one. I think the art is beautiful, it's this very typical comic book style. And if you like the Shades of Magic series, you'll like this as well. It has pirates. Now we come to a few fun ones. On a Sunbeam by Tilly Walden. Again, this is mostly inked by hand. The colors are added digitally, and I'm just amazed by Tilly Walden's output. This as well, you can read online as a webcomic for free, but I really love the bound copy. I think the art is beautiful, and it's just the ombre effect throughout the pages is stunning. The story is deeply emotional. It's queer, spacey, and stunning. And you can see Tilly Walden is also known for spinning, which should come up really, really soon. Let's hope this pile doesn't fall over too often. Here we are. Spinning by Tilly Walden is her autobiographical graphic novel about growing up as a competitive figure skater and coming out as a lesbian, as queer, and it's absolutely stunning and really emotional and has this beautiful yellow, light purple, pink, violet color palette. I ordered her sketchbook recently on Etsy, which shows more of her art style. It's not a graphic novel per se, but I thought I'd include it in this video just to show what a big fan I am of Tilly Walden as a creator. And here are the tools she uses, which I find very interesting, how she just uses everything and mixes and matches and just is so prolific. She publishes so often. Another one by Uli Lust, which I should have included earlier, but not written by her, so she just did the illustration. Again, you have this beautiful, sketchy style that is quite fun. I'm not sure if this has an English translation, though. Right. So, running out of room to fit more graphic novels on screen, and they're starting to fall over. Mouse, of course, is an absolute graphic novel classic. It's just so well done, the way the panels are laid out. It's set in the Second World War, as you can see, and it just is so, so, so good. If you haven't read Mouse yet, do it now. I'm not sure what to tell you to convince you. Emily Carroll, this is a short story collection, all short comics. It's really, really fun. It's a lot more colorful than her other graphic novel, which I'll show in a second, but the stories are very emotional, very spooky, and if you're into thriller, horror, and all of that, this will be something for you. When I Arrived at the Castle is even more beautiful. It's, yeah, it's signed. I'll show you the signatures and doodles that a bunch of these authors did in here for me, but it has this striking color palette, and I really, really love the way she does her panel layouts, or lack of panel layouts, how everything kind of flows and the story progresses through the medium and how she uses that to her advantage. Abbott is a book I got years ago as a present, and it's about a detective in this weird necromancy spooky story, and it has a lot to do about race and identity, and it's just really, really well done. Here is a really, really fun book, Jimmy the Smartest Kid on the Earth. Never know how to put it, as you can see the cover goes always. But there's so many panels and it's so intricate. The style is super, almost like an infographic, super flat, super simple, but just packed full of stories, and it's just a really, really fun read. There's not really much of a story, it's just very entertaining. And if you like this sort of style, this is a book for you. It's also an interesting approach to the medium. Igor-Berichte aus Japan is a mixed-media graphic novel about Igor and his time as one of the first foreign mangaka in Japan. As you can see, the style is different. There's text, there's photographs, there's a bunch of different things going on. There's a few of in this series by now, and I believe it's translated to multiple languages. This is the German translation. I believe it's French originally, I'm not quite sure, but this is also a fun one. He meets Hayao Miyazaki, and there's just a lot going on and a lot to tell, and it's also very informative. So yeah, I forgot these two. I hope you like them as well. I just really love how the art is so varied and unique, but also just very expressive as well, mixing these traditional Japanese styles with this more modern Western graphic novel style. Here are the signatures. I think I showed you this before. Please enjoy Emily Carroll. And also in Through the Woods, she did a little doodle, which is really, really cute. I love when artists and graphic novelists don't just sign, but also doodle something. Tilly Walden also drew herself in Spinning, and then her main character in On a Sunbeam with a white gel pen, which I think is just so cute. And they're all dedicated to Jona, because the Erich Friedtage in Austria, in Vienna, every 2 years has a graphic novels day, so they are slowly making their way through every famous graphic novelist there is. This one, I couldn't actually make it to the event, so my boyfriend got it signed, so that's why he wrote "Where Were You?" to Jona. He did this entire illustration. Craig Thompson was really fun, because he was like, tell me what to draw, and he'd draw whatever, and not just the same little doodle in all of them. The same in Habibi. Right. There that is. There that is. There's that. Scott McCloud didn't draw in any of them, so he just wrote my name and signed. But yeah, those are all the graphic novels, and I hope you enjoyed this. And if you want to see other recommendation videos, calligraphy and so on, I'll see you in the next video.